Now, your WLKY weather with Matt Milosevich.
Well, good morning, everyone. It is 4:54, and we're live on Fern Valley Road at the I-65 overpass there, and you can see that the roads are passable, but they are snow-packed this morning, so keep that in mind. You're going to need a lot of extra time as you head on out in the wintry weather that continues across the region. Winter storm warnings are in effect with the exception of Jackson, Jennings, and Lawrence counties as you head southward through the metro and especially into the southern half of the viewing area. We are by no means done with the snow as through the morning. It's going to continue to be very wintry and at times quite treacherous as you make your way out on the roads. Now the plowed roads, the treated roadways, again, they're going to be passable, not in the best of conditions because we're still putting snow on them. So it's going to take this storm system winding down later this morning and even a little bit of afternoon sunshine to really help improve travel conditions. But the road crews are out and doing the best they can this morning, and I'll just help them out, give them a wide space to do their job too as you pass around them and just try to be safe overall this morning. You can see steady snow in the metro, and that continues all the way back off to the west till you hit Owensboro. A little bit of a break, though, into western and southwestern Kentucky, but another round is off towards the west. Speaking of a break, snow ending. Paoli, Salem, Scottsburg, Madison, up to North Vernon and Seymour. You're not going to see much more in the way of any additional snow, but from the metro southward, that's where we're going to continue to see some snow showers and accumulating snow through at least the mid-morning hours, because we have another batch off to the west that has to move on through before we say goodbye to this storm system, and good riddance as well. 15 degrees in Paoli and Seymour, 19 in the metro, but wind chills are in the single digits. As we move through the day, it's going to continue to be cold, highs only near 24, even as skies turn partly sunny. Definitely a frigid night ahead, 17 by 10 o'clock on way to a low of 8. No thawing tomorrow with highs in the 20s at 28 degrees. We get a slight chance Wednesday at 36, but a better chance to melt and thaw out for the end of the week and into the weekend. Highs still well below normal. We should be in the 50s, but 40s will feel nicer and will give us a chance to get rid of the snow and ice.
Absolutely. And at least a few days coming up where we don't have to deal with this on the morning commute. I mean, this is the recurring theme this winter.
It has been.
Snowing to ruin the morning commute.
I know, right? It's tough, and you know what? Maybe someday we'll actually get school back on track as well.
Yeah.
No kidding. All right. Well, Natalie's been standing by in the traffic center for us all morning, keeping us up to date on any problem spots. What's going on right now, Natalie?
Yeah, Lexi, not problem-free out there, but so far just one accident. Crews still assisting about four stalled vehicles at last check. But again, most of the metro area just moving slowly because of the snow that's out there. So check out the map. All of those areas of red are where you can expect to do under the speed limit, and there's quite a few of them this morning. Again, not too many accidents reported. We're just dealing with this one on the Watterson in the westbound lanes around Bardstown Road. So it's one of those mornings where there's so much snow out there, you just need to leave early.